Hello everyone. My name is Utkarsh Mittal and I'm a Senior Product Manager at AWS. In this demo, I will walk you through how you can publish tables in your AWS Glue Data Catalog to Amazon DataZone. Publishing an Amazon DataZone means adding a data asset such as a table or a view to the DataZone Business Data Catalog. As a data producer, you can publish your data assets with technical and business metadata so that data consumers can discover them and request access to them. Publishing AWS Glue tables involves three steps. You start with a project. You can create a new project or use an existing one. In the project, you will need to create a data lake environment. Environments in DataZone provide you the necessary infrastructure and permissions to be able to work with data. Next, you will need an AWS Glue data source within the project and run it. The data source automatically reads the technical metadata, such as the name, location and schema of the tables in your AWS Glue Data Catalog and creates assets in DataZone using that metadata. Finally, you can publish the asset to the Business Data Catalog. When publishing, you can curate the metadata and add necessary business context. In the publishing step, we will also explore automated metadata generation feature of DataZone that automatically generates business names of tables and columns instead of you having to provide them manually. Now, before we jump into the DataZone portal and start publishing, let's understand what permissions DataZone will need to be able to access your data in the AWS Glue Data Catalog. You can grant the necessary permissions in AWS Lake Formation to the Manage Access IAM role. This is the IAM role used to enable the Data Lake Blueprint in your account. You will have to provide two specific sets of permissions. First, describe and describe grantable permissions to the database where your tables exist. And then select and describe permission, as well as the select and describe grantable permissions to the tables that you want to publish. These permissions allow DataZone to read the technical metadata of the databases and tables that you want to publish, and also grant access to other users on your behalf. If you do not use AWS Lake Formation to manage your data lake, you can provide IAM permissions, but in that case, DataZone will not be able to grant access to others on your behalf. You can refer to DataZone's user guide to learn more about these permissions. Now, coming back to publishing, we have DataZone set up in an AWS account, and in that same account, we have an AWS Glue database called Store Sales with five tables that we will publish to DataZone. So let's jump into the DataZone portal and start by creating a project. For this, we will open this project dropdown at the top and select Create Project. Provide a name and description and create the project. Now, within this project, we will create a data lake environment. We will click on the Create Environment button, provide a name and description for the environment. Next, we will pick an environment profile. An environment profile is a predefined template that includes technical details to create an environment, such as which AWS account and region should the environment be created in, what resources and tools should be deployed. Here, we will pick the data lake profile. You can ignore all the other advanced settings and create the environment. It will take about a minute for the environment to create, but once it's ready, we can create a data source. To create a data source, you first need to select the project where you want to create the data source. Here, my project is already selected, so I'll go to the Data tab. Click on the Data Sources and create new data source. We will provide a name and description for the data source. Next, we will pick the data source type as AWS Glue Data Catalog. We will pick the environment that we have just created, and then we will select what data we want to bring in. For database, we will provide the name of our database, which is store underscore sales. Then for the table, we can provide the name of each table individually, or we can provide a string pattern using a wildcard. In our case, all our tables start with sales. So let's provide sales star. This means that data source will bring in all the tables that start with sales. Next, we will provide some additional details. First, publish settings. With publish settings, you can specify if you want to publish the assets created by the data source directly to the Business Data Catalog, or you want to bring them over as inventory first. For this demo, let's keep the assets in the inventory so that we can enrich the metadata of these assets before others can start discovering them in the catalog. The next setting allows you to enable or disable automated metadata generation or business name generation. We will keep it on so that DataZone automatically generates business metadata for us. Next, we can attach metadata forms. Metadata forms allow you to add custom business metadata to your assets in the catalog. Let's pick a metadata form here. We will pick the ownership form, which will allow us to add details of who are the owners. These metadata forms are not provided by DataZone out of the box, but you can create them based on your organization's requirements. Let's quickly provide values of the fields in these metadata forms. Next, you can pick schedule if you want to run the data source on a specific day and time. And that's it. You can review all the details you provided and create the data source. Now the data source has been created, let's run it. Once it has finished running, you will see that it has created 5 new assets. Now these assets are added as inventory, which means only the members of the project can see them. To make them discoverable, we will need to publish them to the catalog. So let's see how that looks like. Let's open one of the assets. We can see that DataZone brought in a bunch of technical metadata, such as name of the table, where it is located, and the schema of the table with all the columns and their data types. Also, you see these icons here? This indicates that DataZone has generated business names automatically. You can simply accept these recommendations if they look correct to you, instead of providing these manually. On the schema tab also, you can see that it generates business labels for each column. These business names look correct to me, so I'll just simply accept all the recommendations. In addition to the business names, you can also provide other business metadata. For example, you can provide the description of your asset. You can also provide a README text. You can also attach business glossary terms to your data asset. Under schema, for each individual column in your table, you can provide a description of the column. You can also attach business glossary terms to individual columns in your asset. So now that we have added all the business metadata, we can publish this asset using the Publish button, which makes it discoverable in the catalog. To test, let's type sales in the search bar, and we can see that this asset is now showing up in the search results. So just to recap, we saw in this demo how you can bring in data from your AWS Glue data catalogs to Amazon DataZone. That is all we have for this demo. Thank you for watching.